Do you think that you live forever?
Yes.
No, all of us know very well that we will not live forever. But we always try to put this thought into sleep as it scares us. My wake-up call from the sleep came on 28th of February last, when my father passed away at the age of 76. During his last days, he was not surrounded by the family members, but hospital staffs. He passed away in ICU within 48 hours while we were waited outside in that hospital, because we were not allowed as per SOP of the hospital. Though we violated that SOP and have a rear glance of him in these days, it was by no means an easy task to achieve. Now when I'm trying to heal and moving with the time, I found some measure of catharsis in sharing my story with my friends and colleagues. But today, over here, more than sharing my story, I'm interested to describe some of my old, long-held, cherished assumptions about the people who are about to die or who are in a dying process. Now, when some reflections, I mean, out of these 2 months emerged, I just thought, why not structure those reflections in for my project? But let me begin from a very personal convention. I'm very much afraid today, you know, and I think I'm not alone. A recent survey in USA said 8 out of 10 people behave and think as if they are immortal, while we all know this immortality is a myth which bears no relevance to reality. In reality, the only thing which is certain in life is death. It is so common that some 2 weeks ago I was reading an article in British weekly magazine The Economist. It says that 100 people throughout the world die in a single minute. By that standard, by the end of this 7 minutes talk, we are going to lose 700 people around the world who used to walk on the surface of the earth. Now, contrary to my fear to the death, I found that the scariest thing the dying people have is not death or the dying. They are scared about the days leading to the death and the regrets they think they have. For example, whether they have carved a niche for themselves or their families while they are alive, or do they cause any misfortune for anybody? In the end, and here is my reflection one, in the end, I think for them, death is one thing, regret is quite another. And contrary to popular perception, it is the regret part which is always worrisome for them. Now, my second reflection, suffering is old, in old age is always a part of the process. But I believe now that some of the suffering has been invented by our hospitals. We all know that our healthcare system, even in private sector, has their fair share of dysfunctions. You know, it doesn't mean that I believe that we should not bring our people to the hospital for treatment. Only an insane person can deny the miracle the medical science has brought in the last few centuries. What I'm trying to say is referring the wishes of those people who want to be with their dear ones in the last days of their life. And lesser extent, I'm also referring the agony of the people who sit outside of the hospital and wait for the inevitable to happen. So, you know, now I don't know, how can I say, I think if you think that promoting or peddling some objectionable ideas or promoting some questionable facts, because it is after all striking a very precarious balance, I mean, between the two. It is like walking on a tight rope. But in the end of the day, what I think, and at the cost of being awkward, I would say that hospital should not be a place for dying. Now, I personally, I will be as fearful to death in my dying days as I am today at this moment in this hall. But what I believe is that I need to be surrounded by my family when my mind flickers one last time.